There's always that one show that we remember that can be funny, but you look back at it and there's a few problematic stuff in there, but it's still funny. Yeah, that's Oblongs. With its obvious commentary about disability, being low income, and the privilege. Oblongs is a family of six. The father, who only has his torso, his wife, who has an addiction to hair loss, the twin older brothers who are conjoined, a middle child who has mental health issues, and the baby who is an added physical feature to her. And Milo has his friends who I won't be bothering to go into. Oblongs isn't perfect. I know this. Character being transgender as the butt of the jokes is annoying, especially since it would have been an amazing chance for the show to explore being transgender while in poverty. Now, Helga, like her whole thing's being fat, she's heavy, haha, 2000s humor. Helga could have had a storyline that has something to do with her struggling with overeating while being poor, and of course, literally any stereotypes that the episode calls for. That's why I honestly didn't bother with some of the episodes because they made me a bit uncomfortable. Episode 1's plot is that Milo wants to go to quote-unquote normal school. The episode starts with Milo complaining about it while he goes to one meant for psychos. This 9 out of 10 reflects how we demonize those with mental illnesses and disabilities. And it was really, really, really bad back then, and still is bad now. Oblong school signs are honestly a genius and funny gag. In this sign, it says making kids average since 1945. Outright stating that the goal of a lot of programs isn't meant to have people's mental needs met and make it less difficult for them to navigate through life, to make it so they accommodate with other people so they're more comfortable with them. I really had extra lessons on how to properly interact with people, and yet the woman who was teaching me that couldn't confront people for shit. Anyway, this show is mixed with disability. It's the reason for some of the visual gags in the show. When we see Mr. Oblong, he's finding ways to do something differently so that suits him because he doesn't have the limbs for it. He's enjoying his life with Mr. Red Suit making degrading remarks towards him, same with Biff and Chip. Now here's the thing with Milo, again, it's a mixed bag. He has moments where people are talking him down because of his mental illness and disability, but they also use it as a base for the jokes where he does the most out-of-pocket things. Hence the lockdown room.
And so, the sexual odyssey of these two strangers breaks every taboo, leading to an unforgettable 9.5 weeks.
Mm. Read me another video box, Mommy.
No, honey, it's time to board the sleepy train to Slumberland, where fairies make all your sweet dreams come true.
Lockdown!
Oh, Mom, I'm fully medicated.
Milo, last night you were up till dawn trying to circumcise ants.
That's not crazy. It's a matter of hygiene.
The intro really says a lot with how poor people get the shit side of any deal. Episode 3, as stated by Pickle, their air is literally toxic from all the poison in the valley. Not only that, but as soon as the hill kids cause trouble, the valley kids are the ones who are their scapegoats and take the blame. Commercialized kids' toys being expensive for only the middle class enough to buy them for the kids to enjoy mean that the baby can't get her doll or possibly become a lesbian. So episode 6, Manic. Mr. Oblong was full on ready to chuck Milo and take credit of Manic. Yes, I know he gave in at the end. Which I'm pretty sure that commentates on how energy drinks are scams and how easily it is to get addicted to it, but more socially acceptable, just like coffee. Just gonna add this, by the way. I'm gonna be quick with the rest of it because I'm tired of talking. Poor kids usually give something up to make money to live comfortably and maybe support their families. This episode is basically how being gifted is just that, and Milo's dad is trying to live through him. Unfortunately, a lot of parents do that.
Question, but it got burned up. How do they know?
Addiction can, yes, happen to rich people and stuff. However, it's more prevalent and a problem in poor communities. As soon as she married Pickles, as soon as she married Bob, started drinking and smoking. In episode 5, she doesn't lose the addiction, she simply changes her addiction, that being adrenaline junkie. As soon as she married Bob, she started smoking and drinking. As soon as she married Bob, she started smoking and drinking. And in episode 5, she doesn't lose her addiction, she simply changes her addiction, that being an adrenaline junkie. Mr. Red Suit has a company that is literally called Globicide. The hill people are rich to the point that middle class is a joke and a lie because of the money gap. He runs a corrupt company that does animal testing and puts workers in hazardous conditions. For the Debbies, there's a resentment and admiration for rich kids at school, which is honestly relatable. They're the standard for everything while being a copy-paste of each other with no personality. Something that I think really adds to it is that a good chunk of disabled people come from marginalized communities and poor areas, and trust me, adding that to healthcare is a pain in the ass. The thing is, Mr. Oblong is also very guilty of this. Like, he definitely has his racist moment out there and subtle. And in this episode where he stated the idea of Milo dressing in drag. By the way, if the show wasn't cancelled, it would have been a great way to explore Milo's gender identity. When Mr. Oblong gets his robot body, he lets it get to his head and was 100% ready to leave everyone else behind and have the privilege all to himself. This as well.
The prayer in the parenting manual. Dear white male god, please send down a cleansing fire to rid us of the mud races. Whew.
Episode 6. Mr. Oblong has his ideas for the company written down, and yet 20 years they never used one idea. He's a poor disabled man, but he still has other privileges and loves the system to death because he's under the illusion that he can one day work his way up that corporate ladder. I'd like to say for episode 8, we can love an unbothered queen and a happy creep. Oblongs is a genuinely great show.
Because I forgot to record the ending, I'd like to say that Oblongs can be a genuinely funny show. It'd be nice to see it be revamped without more of the problematic stuff in it, and how it takes today's social commentary. Anyway, that's the end. Bye-bye.